Good morning, students. So, I am doing unit 2, in unit 2, session number 16. So, that is what are the course outcomes of this session? To understand the construction and working of oil circuit breaker. And what are the contents you study in this session? Construction and working of oil circuit breakers. Advantages and disadvantages of oil circuit breakers. Next, applications of oil circuit breakers. So, that means in this session, we totally will study about the construction, working, the advantages and disadvantages, applications of plain break, oil circuit breaker. So that means everybody should observe the figure. Plain break oil circuit breaker is the earliest type from which all other circuit breakers are developed. So that means it is the basic type in which all other circuit breakers will be developed. It has very simple construction and it consists of fixed parts, the fixed contacts and the moving contacts enclosed in a strong weather tight earth tank, containing oil up to a certain level, and an air cushion, above the oil level. Here, what is the use of air cushion? The air cushion provides the sufficient room to allow the reception of hot gases without generation of unsafe pressure in the dome of the circuit breaker. That means, whenever the short circuit occurs, here any pressure created in the oil. So that is because of the gases, the any pressure created in the oil, so that will be avoided with this air cushion. Under normal operating conditions, the fixed and moving contacts remains closed and the breaker carries the normal current. Breaker carries the normal current. So that means here under normal operating conditions, usually the moving contact and the fixed contact will be closed. It will be in closed condition. And the current will flow normally, or we can say the normal current will be flowing. So whenever the fault occurs, the moving contact or are pulled out, and an arc is struck, which vaporizes the oil mainly into hydrogen gas. So that means how the hydrogen gas will be produced. So usually at the separation of the contacts, the arc will be produced. When that arc reacts with the oil, the transformer oil, the hydrogen gas will be produced. So what is the hydrogen gas? That is, what is the main advantage of hydrogen gas? What is the function it will do? The hydrogen gas bubble generated around the arc cools the arc column and aids the deionization of the medium between the contacts. That means the hydrogen gas bubble generated around the arc, it will cool. That means hydrogen gas, it acts as a cooling medium. And it aids the deionization of the medium between the contacts. So deionization, what is the difference between ionized, ionization, deionization, or so what do you mean by ionized state and the deionized state? Ionized state means under normal operating conditions. So under the normal current will be flowing. Under short circuit conditions, at the time of separation of the contacts, or we can say at the time of the, that is the time at which the two contacts will be open, at that time, what happens? The temperature will be produced. So that is, we can say it is around more than 3000 degrees centigrade. In such cases, here it is a ionized state means the temperature at which still the fault current will be flowing between the contacts. And the circuit is not completely interrupted. So that is called the ionized state. The ionized state means the state at which still the fault current will be flowing between the two contacts. So that is the ionized state. So next day what happens after some time, so after normal current zero, or in the other sense we can say, in the methods of arc extension, we have high resistance method and the low resistance of zero current method. So here we have two methods. In this plane break, we use the low resistance of the current zero method we use. Here, what do you mean by current zero method? If you consider the sine wave, under fault conditions, when actually the contacts will be separated, means when the fault current will be in the AC wave, it comes to the zero. In sine wave, when it comes to the zero, at that zero position, the contacts will be separated. At the zero position, in sine wave, the contacts will be separated. So that is called as the current zero method. It is also called as low voltage method. So therefore here the method of arc extension we use is low resistance method. So when when it will stop flowing of current, then we will say it is a deionization state. So therefore hydrogen gas bubble generated around the arc, it cools the arc column and it aids the deionization of the medium between the contacts. So that means the circuit is completely interrupted. Next, the gas sets up turbulence in the oil and helps in eliminating the arcing products from the arc part. So that means it's like it will be very rough. Or in the other sense, it is violent in such a cases. So whatever the arc products, present between the two contacts, this hydrogen gas, it will completely eliminate the arcing products. So that is the property of the hydrogen gas. So next, here as the arc lengthens due to the separation of contacts, the dielectric strength of the medium is increased. Here, what is the main property of this, transformer oil or mineral oil used in this plane break circuit breakers? At the time of the separation of the contacts, as the arc lengthens, that means as the arc length will be increased due to the separation of the contacts, the dielectric strength of the medium will be increased. Because at that time, at the separation of the contacts, dielectric strength has to increase. So it has to increase so that immediately within a microsecond, we can quench the arc. we can quench the arc. Otherwise what happens, if the electric strength will not increase, so the total contacts will be burned out. The total contacts will be burned out, and then there may be a continuous flow of current in the other parts connected to the circuit breaker. So the result of these actions is that at some critical gap length, the result of these actions is that some critical gap length, the arc is extinguished and the circuit current is interrupted. So that is the main thing. At normal current zero, the arc will be extinguished and the circuit will be interrupted. So what I explained, the low resistance are current zero with it. So next, what are the main advantages of oil circuit breakers? So usually it is an earliest type of circuit breaker. Here what are the main advantages? The gases formed due to oil decomposition. The gases formed due to oil decomposition has good cooling properties. So that means whatever the gases produced at the time of the arc, it is having the good cooling properties. So next, arc energy is easily absorbed by the oil due to its decomposition. Due to its arc energy, that means here at the separation of the contacts, the arc energy will be more. In the other sense, you can say the temperature surrounding between the contacts will be around more than 3000 degrees centigrade. So in such cases, it is easily absorbed by the oil due to its decomposition property. So next, the cooling surfaces formed by surrounding oil is close to the arc. The cooling surfaces formed by the surrounding oil is close to the arc. So that is one thing. So it is very close to the arc, therefore easily, so that within the shortest time, so it will be quenched. The arc will be quenched. So next advantage, after current zero, the flow of cool oil flows in the contact space which is having high dielectric strength. So that means after the separation of the contacts, the contact space which is having high dielectric strength, therefore even the arc quenching is within the shortest time, complete arc will be quenched. And one more advantage means whatever the oil used, it acts as a good insulator. That means it is having the good insulating properties. Whatever the oil used, it is having the good insulating properties. So what are the main disadvantages of oil circuit breaker? So main disadvantage is there is no special control over the arc other than increase in length by separating the moving contacts. So generally here what happens, because of the pressure while opening the contacts, here length will be increased. Here the length of the arc will be increased. So therefore for successful interruption, long arc length is necessary. Because whatever the gas, at the time of separation of the arc, whatever the gas liberated, so usually it has the high insulating property, because of which even for long arc length, so that means arc quenching will be very easy. So next, these breakers have long and inconsistent arcing times. So that is one disadvantage. So that means whatever may be the circuit breakers, so it has to quench the arc within a microseconds. Here it takes more time when compared to other circuit breakers. So this plain break oil circuit breakers, it will take more time, more arcing time. So next, these breakers do not permit high speed interruption. So that is one main disadvantage. So that means at the time of fault, so that means it every circuit breaker within a shortest period it has to interrupt. So it has to interrupt. But when compared to other circuit breakers, it takes somewhat more time when compared to other circuit breakers. Next is applications. Here the basically plain break high circuit breakers are used only for low voltage applications where high braking capacities are not important. So that means here only some applications where the low voltage, only for low voltage applications, these plain break high circuit breakers will be used. So that is, it is nothing but therefore they are used for low capacity installations for voltages not exceeding 11 kV. Usually we can say that means low rating substations are the substations are this the power stations which is having the low ratings, that means up to 11 kV. Up to 11 kV the plain break oil circuit breakers will be preferred. So this is about the construction advantages, the disadvantages and applications of plain break oil circuit breakers. Next, after end of the sessions, let us discuss about the multiple choice questions. So first multiple choice question: the quantity of oil needed for arc control, for quantity of oil needed for arc control, oil circuit breakers is dash than oil that of plain break oil circuit breakers. That means here, so how much quantity of oil will be required when compared to other circuit breakers? So what are the answers? The answers are the more, less, medium and equal. Among all the four, the first one A, that means it requires more quantity of oil than the other circuit breakers. So next multiple choice: the plain break oil circuit breakers is the dash type from which all other circuit breakers have developed. The plain break oil circuit breakers is the dash type from which all other circuit breakers have developed. So the answers are earliest, latest, oldest, all of the above. Among all the four answers, earliest is the right answer because it is an earliest type of circuit breaker. Next, in an oil circuit breaker, dash is used as the arc quenching medium. Dash oil will be used as an arc quenching medium. The answers are mineral oil, transformer oil, engine oil, all of the above. So among all the four choices, mineral oil will be used as an arc quenching medium. Next, fourth one, plain break oil circuit breakers are used only for dash voltages. That is, plain break oil circuit breakers will be used for which range of voltages? So that is, the choices are low, medium, high, all of the above. So among four choices, so which is the right answer? First one, low. Low voltages. Plain break oil circuit breakers are used only for low voltages. So fifth question: plain break oil circuit breakers do not permit speed interruption. Plain break oil circuit breakers do not permit speed interruption. So the choices are high, low, medium, all of the above. That means plain brake oil circuit breakers do not permit dash speed interruption. So among all the four answers, so which will be the right answer? High speed interruption. That means plain brake oil circuit breakers do not permit high speed interruption. That means it's not possible here. So it takes more time for interruption. So this is about the multiple choice questions. So for any queries or any feedback or any suggestions, say everybody, you can contact this website lms.dtech@gmail.com. Thank you.